In Pittsburgh, at the Human Engineering Research Laboratories, VA is making a significant contribution to the engineering of wheelchair and associated rehabilitation solutions. In fact, it's been consistently named by VA as a research center of excellence. Supported by the VA Pittsburgh Healthcare System, HERL, as it's commonly called, is a collaborative effort between VA and the University of Pittsburgh.
Ever since the Human Engineering Research Laboratories opened its doors in 1994, the science of wheelchair design and engineering has never been the same.
The Human Engineering Research Laboratories are essential to the VA's research mission. What we do here is develop tools and technologies for VA clinicians to improve the services that they provide to veterans, and technologies actually used by veterans to improve their quality of life, their function, and preserve their health.
And when we say improving quality of life, we want them to be able to experience more recreational activities, work activities, enjoyment at home, anything to maximize their ability to lead a full life, even though they have a mobility impairment.
Well, the mission of the Human Engineering Research Laboratories is very personal to me. I'm a veteran, an Army veteran with a spinal cord injury. And use, in many ways, I'm the guinea pig for some of our technology.
Made up of 8 research labs, HERL is staffed by a small army of investigators, engineers, machinists, clinicians, and research specialists. Also on board are graduate students and medical interns who are specializing in the field of rehabilitation.
Dr. Boninger and I, from the beginning, wanted to create an environment where we could start from concept and go all the way to clinical trial.
Doctors Cooper and Boninger emphasize that this type of research is complex and takes time.
One of our studies is this simple transfer study where we're watching a veteran move from one location to another. That may seem like a simple study, but in fact, what it makes the biggest difference for independence, for an individual, for a veteran, is their ability to get from a bed to a wheelchair to a lounge chair to watch TV.
So the individual motion capture cameras that we have are recording three-dimensional positioning of the upper limbs in the individual joints, the wrist, elbow, and the shoulder.
Research is science, so it is challenging. It takes patience, it takes intelligence, it takes teamwork. So we do both research and development. Research can take years, decades. There's never an overnight solution in research. And good research typically answers some questions and exposes new questions.
In HERL's robotics laboratory, engineers are working hard to find solutions to seemingly simple everyday activities, ones that can be difficult to perform if you have a disability. For instance, they're examining how to open something like a microwave oven when a person has lost the use of their arms. To resolve that problem, they're developing a device called the Personal Mobility and Manipulation Appliance, or PERMA.
Our research is focused on improving the quality of veterans' lives today. The only place we've been able to get the kind of funding that enables us to work on improving veterans' lives today at the level that we need to do this work is the VA. If we see a new engineering device or I see a new medical device and I say, boy, that has value to veterans, I can then research that, do the pilot studies that enable us to get larger studies off and actually bring a product to a veteran to improve their lives.
There are literally hundreds of devices in use today that are bringing a sense of normalcy to the lives of the disabled, ones that are the direct result of HERL's research.
We've individually at this lab patented a number of devices. There are 2 devices that are patented, being commercially sold, and are used all over the world right now.
One of the devices mentioned by Dr. Boninger is the push rim, developed for use on wheelchairs.
So we developed a push rim that's been patented and is now being manufactured and called the Natural Fit. This push rim has an oval-shaped gripping surface, and so when you grab onto it, it actually fits the natural shape of the hand. It also has a low-friction surface here that makes it easier to brake when you're trying to go down a hill, and a high-friction surface right